What's good, beautiful people? It's your girl. I'm still Asia, baby. Cause every time I close my eyes, I see you.
Hey, you gonna have me
welcome
dancing over
back
here.
To my channel, ladies and gentlemen. If you are new here, hello, hello, and welcome. Okay, be sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any videos from your girl. Okay,
gotta believe it.
As y'all can see, I got BJ in here today
in the flesh.
Okay,
back like I never left.
Back like we never left. Back like we never left.
Back in the building, y'all.
I'm going to make me a whole song, okay? Off of Back Like We Never Left. Anyway, y'all, if y'all didn't know, Asia and BJ have a channel together. Y'all need to check it out. Tap in if you haven't already. It is Asia and BJ, okay?
Absolutely.
Just like that.
Y'all pull up. Let us know.
Yeah. As y'all can see from the thumbnail today, y'all, I'm getting into, this is Chris Rock, Black People versus the N-word, okay? Bring the Pain, 1996.
Yeah, we're going back.
Yeah.
Ooh. 96. I can probably like barely remember like when this came out.
Hey, I feel like this was the time when sensitive people weren't here all the way yet. Okay, for them to have a title like this. What you think?
Chris Rock was already, you know, he was already on that level. You know what I mean? They was already kind of going in to that degree. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but
with the raw content and the raw titles and stuff like that.
He was, but I'm just like, you know, I don't know. Because today I feel like they wouldn't put no video out like this. They just wouldn't do that. Not like this.
Yeah.
Definitely. You think so?
Absolutely.
Okay, well, Chris Rock.
Even in their stand-up. Like, if you haven't seen Dave Chappelle recently, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
He's off the chain?
Off the chain. It's raw.
Dave Chappelle is off chain.
It's raw. You know, they're going to keep it raw. They're comedians, so, you know, they got to go there.
Okay.
They got to go there.
I mean, maybe I'm wrong. I'm like, this is before the sensitive people kind of kicked in, y'all, because I'm just like, I don't even want to.
I could probably agree with that part as far as, like, this was kind of before, you know.
Yeah. Okay.
This different culture, this different era, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, hey. I ain't finna keep this video long, y'all. This video is long enough. So go on and get your popcorn ready. And let's go on and get into this video, y'all.
Absolutely.
Ow. All right. Let's do this.
Now, we got a lot of things. A lot of racism going on in the world right now. Who's more racist, Black people or white people? Black people. You know why? Because we hate Black people, too. Black people don't like about black people. There's some shit going on with Black people right now. It's like a civil war going on with Black people. And there's two sides. It's Black people and there's niggas. Niggas have got to go. Every time Black people want to have a good time, ignorant ass niggas fuck up.
Man, it's always somebody to come in that just kills the vibe. Okay, you go from drunk to just stupid. Okay, you're like.
Right now, just sit back, relax. This is gonna be a real quick lesson in regards to the differentiation between the two.
Oh God.
For real. Talk that talk.
That's why people popping it. They're like, yeah.
Talk that talk.
Ignorant. Disco open more than 3 weeks. Grand opening, grand
closing.
Can't go to a movie the first week and come out. Why? Because niggas are shooting at the screen. What kind of ignorant shit is that? Hey, that's a good movie. That's so good, I got to bust a cap in here. Hey, I love Black people, but I hate niggas, bro. Boy, I wish they let me join the Ku Klux Klan.
No. No.
I'm here to Brooklyn. Tired of niggas, man. You can't have shit when you're around niggas. You can't have shit. You can't have no big screen TV. You can have it, but you better move it in at 3 in the morning.
See, he touching on it right there. Like back, you know, back then, like when you finna move in, that was like the code to move in the middle of the night. Yeah. So people couldn't see what you're moving.
That, y'all. that's straight up how we moved so up the, at Oak Cliff.
So then don't see you.
Yeah, y'all. Real talk though. I remember we used to do that. I remember we moved from Oak Cliff and we moved in the middle and I was like, why are we moving at night?
At night. Yeah.
We straight up.
Grand opening, grand closing.
You can have it, but you better move it in at 3 a.m. Painted white, hope niggas think it's a bassinet. Can't have shit in your house. Why? Because niggas will break in your house. Niggas will live next door to you, break in your house, and come over the next day and go, I heard you got robbed.
Sad.
Come on now.
Like, nigga, you know you robbed me. You ain't hear shit because you was doing shit. Want some credit for some shit they supposed to do. For some shit they just supposed to do. A nigga will brag about some shit a normal man just does. A nigga will say some shit like, I take care of my kids. You supposed to, you dumb motherfucker.
For real.
What kind of ignorant shit is that? I ain't never been to jail. What, you want a cookie?
You know, expectation happens. Bruh.
Fuck, man. I'm tired of this shit. You know what the worst thing about niggas? The worst thing about niggas? Niggas love to not know. Nothing make a nigga happier than not knowing the answer to your question. Just ask a nigga a question. Any nigga. Hey, nigga, what's the capital of Zaire? I don't know that shit. Keeping it real. Niggas love to keep it real. Real dumb.
No, man, wait.
He is going all right now.
They love to keep it real. Real dumb.
Yeah. Man, come on. Like, Chris Rock, like, right now, man. He landed all on the line to show you differentiation. Man. And it's okay because there is a differentiation sometimes between the two. That we gotta let you know.
However you want to work that out, okay? Like, literally, however you want to work that out.
You know, there is a battle going on within the black community. You know what I mean? Between the differentiation between the two. We gotta separate it.
No.
Niggas hate now. Shit. Niggas are breaking your house. You want to save your money? Put it in your books. Because niggas don't read. Just put the money in the books. Shit, books are like kryptonite to a nigga.
No, man.
Tired of this shit, man. Your kids can't fucking play nowhere. Every year the space gets smaller. Okay, you go from that corner to that corner. Oh, you go from that gate to that gate. By the time motherfuckers 10, he's just hopping in a circle like.
Can't go nowhere.
No.
Tired of this shit, man. Boy, I hate a nigga. Boy, I'm tired of this shit, man. Tired, man. Niggas is ignorant. Love being there. Singing about ignorance. I heard some song the other day. It's the first of the month. Niggas are singing welfare carol. On the first day of welfare, my true love gave to me. I wish you a merry welfare in a happy food stand.
No, man.
What the fuck is going on? Now they got some shit they're trying to get rid of welfare. So every time you see welfare in the news, they always show black people. Black people don't give a fuck about welfare. Niggas are shaking in their boots. Or they gonna take our shit. Shit, a black man that got 2 jobs, going to work every day, hacks a nigga on welfare. Like, nigga, get a job. I got 2, you can't get one?
Right. Hey. Right.
Clap to that. Clap to that.
A black woman that got 2 kids going to work every day, busting her ass, hates a bitch with 9 kids getting a welfare check. Like, bitch, stop fucking. Stop fucking.
No.
He hit it right on the nail. Because you know, man.
Stop having kids.
Because you know, at some point, you know, back in the day, you know, maybe even now today, like, people be abusing, like, government assistance. They almost use government assistance as, like, as they crutch all the time. Yeah. Like, to bail them out. Almost like that's the thing that they lean on. Like, they don't know anything else to do better.
Yeah, but I also that's think, crazy. Man, they're in a way, though, like, to some degree. I look, and I can't speak for everybody, but I almost feel like the system is almost set up for you to stay in the system. You know what I mean?
It
like,
is.
But
the thing about it is that you're going to stay in the system as long as you want to stay in the system.
Yeah, oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But they make it really hard for you not to want to be. You know what I mean? Especially when you get $600 and $700, $800 a month for food stamps.
HHSC.
Okay?
Yeah.
I'm just saying, like, food stamps, free living, Section 8. Okay? Shoot. Who in a hurry to get off of that?
Mm-hmm. Just especially the free living.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, bitch, stop fucking. Stop fucking. Stop it. Put the dick down. Put it down. Get a job. Yes, you can get a job. And get a job holding dicks. Whatever you do, get paid to do it.
Hey. Okay.
This shit, man.
Tie.
It ain't all black people on welfare. Shit. White people on welfare, too. But we can't give a fuck about them. We just gotta do our own thing. We can't go, oh, they fucked up. We could be fucked up. That's ignorant. White people on the L. Because first of all, they try to make it look like, you know, there ain't even that many black people in the country, okay? Black people are 10% of the fucking population. Black people in New York, D.C., L.A., Chicago, Atlanta, like 10 places, okay?
No.
He said 3 places.
He is a fool.
Ain't no black people in Minnesota. So only black people in Minnesota is Prince and Kirby Puckett.
He said Prince and Kirby Puckett.
Shit, the whole rest of the country, the other 40 states, is filled up with broke-ass white people. Broke-ass, living in a trailer home, eating mayonnaise sandwiches, fucking their sister, listening to John Cougar Mellencamp records.
Not John Cougar Mellencamp. No. No.
He had to go there. Dang. No, he went all the way. He went all the way.
Wow.
Chris Rock, y'all.
I cannot, y'all.
Chris Rock, take it easy. Will Smith might be in the crowd somewhere.
Pump the brakes.
Will Smith might be in the crowd somewhere.
And they need your help. Nah, man. And I see some black people looking at me. Man, why you gotta say that? Why you gotta say that? It ain't us, it's the media. It ain't us, it's the media. The media has distorted our image to make us look bad. Why must you come down on us like that, brother? It ain't us, it's the media. Please cut the fucking shit, okay? 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 When I go to the money machine tonight, all right? I ain't looking over my back for the media. I'm looking for niggas.
Talk that talk, bro. Talk that talk, bro.
No.
Shit. Ted Koppel ain't never took shit from me. Niggas have. So you think I got 3 guns in my house because the media outside? Oh shit, Mike Wallace, run! Fuck out of here, man! Tired of this shit. Tired of this shit.
Listen, I'm tired of this shit.
I mean, hey.
Man, but he laid it on the line, and he laid it on real thick, too. Y'all, he laid it on super thick. And one thing that you got to understand, like I said, you know, there's a differentiation. There's a certain type of black people. And then there's like the super ignorant black people.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying?
They
all the N-word. And again, he's speaking true facts. There is a time. I ain't going to say there is a time because people still do it. But, you know, you, like when you move into like the hood or you move into a certain area, and you got to move at nighttime because you got to make sure you move to make sure don't nobody see what you about to take into the house.
Or take out of it.
Or take out of it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He talking about going to the ATM. I ain't got to look behind my back to look for Brian Gumbel or, you know what I'm saying?
That's so funny that you say that, though.
I got to watch for the ignorant.
I remember moving, like, and I never asked my dad, like, why we did that. I remember, like, why the heck are we moving, like, at nighttime? It's nighttime. Like, and I never understood that. And I never thought about that, actually.
That was a thing back then. We'd do it at nighttime if we got to. And it's kind of crazy to think about that, that you kind of, like, planning your day and kind of doing things based on trying to avoid exposure to ignorant people, black folks. You know what I mean?
That's true, though. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And then he goes on to talk about, like the government assistance, because, again, you got the lazy black people or the ignorant black people that's not really trying to get to a certain point in life where they're just okay with just kind of settling for
nothing. Is like more frustrating than watching like an able-bodied person not want to employ themselves. Like, it just doesn't make any sense. Like, especially when you are perfectly able to do it. You know what I mean? I'm not talking about people disabled, mental. Like, I'm talking about a perfectly able-bodied body. Like, as in you can walk into a place and apply for
get
a job.
Employment. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, and work. You know?
Exactly.
I mean, this is, I'm lost for words. I'm like, look, I don't.
This is like super classic, especially like in the comedic space, because it's like, again, like that's what our entertainers are there to do, like to like lay it, like to say stuff that you think. You know what I mean? And really say it in a verbose way where it's just like, it's just raw and uncut. You know what I mean?
We're going to keep it funky uncut, like but that. It's only to certain, like, I mean, obviously, like you said, it's you got to think about, like, he's talking in particular in regards to, you know, African Americans, if you will, in general. But in essence, I feel like everybody goes through those struggles. There's always, I mean, even in every race, though, you know what I'm saying? No, they aren't they N-word, but they, you know, they're a little bit ratchet, you know what I mean? Like, they're a little bit over the top, like probably people that you probably wouldn't want to have around at a family gathering to bring around your family, you know what I mean? Like, there's one of those for every culture, every race. Like, I feel like that's everywhere. Like, granted, like I said, he is talking about stereotypical type of situations, but
yeah,
I mean, to be fair, I feel like that would be for everybody.
I ain't being fair,
but I'm saying, like, I'm just
because you can't necessarily say that the N-word is particularly just for the black race. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The way that I put it, I just say ignorant, lazy people, and you can put that in any like demographic, any culture, because that's what we're talking about. We're talking about the ignorant, we're talking about the lazy, the ones that's no good, that don't want to do better,
right?
You know what I mean?
That would rather take from people than try to make anything for themselves.
And it's all about a mindset, because, you know, think about a guy sitting here saying that, well, at least I take care of my kids, at least I went and picked them up the other day. Like, I mean, just why like you said, that's voice? Like, bro, that's like what you supposed to do. That's why you a man, you know, you understand what I'm saying? So like I said, it's all about a mindset, and that can be applied to any race when you're dealing with like a demographic.
Absolutely.
Or a certain percentage of that demographic.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The ignorant, lazy ones. You
that's
know what I mean?
Right.
That
no,
you can
I
apply
agree.
To all of them.
I agree. 1,000% agree. That's all I was trying to explain. He just put a label to a name, but.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Like, name to a label. A name, no. None of that. There's no reason to label that if that goes for everybody. You know what I mean? And label it that in particular. But, I mean, for what it was, yeah, it was clever. It was funny. It was bold. It's definitely bold.
But you see how he kind of doubled back after that? He kind of started talking to the black people like, now y'all looking sitting here looking at me like... Here he goes, talking about the black
Why
people.
He
said, I don't give a damn. I'm talking about the... You know what I'm saying? But I like Chris Rock for that, because he doubling down on what he's saying.
Yeah.
He's not backpedaling on.
I mean,
I agree with him, because like I say, we done dealt with people like that. We done been around them. those certain types of ignorant people. Again, like I said, everything that he's saying is true to a degree. If you've been around like that, you know, if you've been in the thick of it, then you know what's going on around here. You know what I mean?
Right.
And if you don't know, then, I mean, you got to watch these videos and learn.
That you don't know.
Because we know from experience. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Okay. I'm just saying from experience.
First hand.
It is what it is, y'all. Take it or leave it. But it's from experience. I'm telling you.
So, hey, if y'all enjoyed this video, be sure you give us a big thumbs up. Like, comment, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell. Join the family. And if ain't nobody told you, I love you. And we're going to see y'all in the next video, y'all. Bye, y'all.